the cars that continued in 66 from the J car. It was a prototype that they had used this kind of honeycomb pattern.
So they sent it out to testing. The car was being tested by Ken Miles. The car broke. He was doing 180 miles an hour. It careened wildly. It was unsurvivable.
They pointed to where he was laying in the dirt. And then I could see he was in pretty bad shape. And then I started to go over there, and they said, don't go.
I've never had a loss that hit me as hard as when we lost Ken. Not only a friend, but he was a good engineer. He was a good test driver. As good a race driver as I ever knew. And I can't say what a void I felt when we lost him.
The loss of Miles was difficult to bear, but losing Shelby, that would destroy the company. It was 1966. This was 6 years after Shelby was told by doctors he only had 5 years left to live.
Jesus Christ, they told you weren't going to live 5 years in 1960, and every 5 years is a new pill or a new operation.
He, in my opinion, knew more than a lot of his doctors. At his bedside, there's stacks of medical journals, and he would read those things voraciously, looking for something that could help cure whatever ailment he had.
Doctor said, you had 40 heart attacks. I used to get an angina attack. I'd just sit down and rest for 5 minutes. And he says, you were having a heart attack all those, probably 40 times.
And I'm a walking chemical depository.
At this point, Shelby had routinely cheated death, which was good news for Ford Motor Company because they needed him now more than ever.
In 1967, when the season began at Daytona, Ford showed up with a full array of upgraded Mark IIs.
Ferrari wanted revenge after 66, and he brought like six cars.
Ma Ferrari venne da me e mi disse, Mario, la P3 ha perso, puoi migliorare la P3.
Quando si vince, molte volte si è portati ad una valutazione erronea dei fattori che hanno determinato la vittoria. Quando si perde, si vede sempre molto chiaro. Quindi, perdendo, si impara a costruire nuove macchine.
Ferrari shows up with brand new cars called the 330 P4. It's beautiful. It looks stunning. It's got a new engine that's derived from their Formula One engine, and it just kicks ass.
It's easy to think of the GT40 as being the iconic car of the time. But the Ferraris that were racing against them were, in their own way, the most sophisticated sports cars ever built.
This was going to be a real showdown and a real race. Ford had all these entries, and they were all big blocks. They started coming in one after the other with broken transmissions.
Only one out of six GT40s finished at Daytona in 1967.
Ferrari won the 24 hours of Daytona with the 1-2-3.
Early in the career, they had not been as durable as the opposition. This is the first time that Ford had ever been slower than the opposition. Something needed to be done, and it wasn't clear how to make the Mark II decidedly faster in a short period of time.
We had a pile of crap. One of them killed Ken Miles out at Riverside. They really needed a lot of development, and we jumped in and did in about 3 months what it had taken Ford a couple of years to screw up back there.
Shelby and his team had to come up with a solution quickly. There was no wind tunnel at the LAX shop, but there was one in Dearborn. Shelby knew what he had to do.
Phil Remington returned to Dearborn with two of his chief fabricators, and they took to the first J-car chassis, and they took it into the wind tunnel.